Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Greetings to you in the gracious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is episode 12 of the encouragement series. And on behalf of all of us from Church of the Resurrection 1004 Estate, Victoria Island, in the Anglican Diocese of Lagos, I say the Lord is with you. I consider it a great privilege to bring the Word of God to you this day. I pray His words will bless your life and that of your household in the name of Jesus Christ. As events around the world keeps unfolding, I want you and I to make the best of the opportunity that we have. A whole lot of people have died in these past few months, no thanks to the pandemic COVID-19. Many died unprepared. I wonder where their souls belong. Is it heaven or hell? I want to encourage us at this time to return to the Lord. I want you and I to get connected to the only one who is able to keep you here an eternity. I believe the time of grace is gradually running out. We should not allow this moment of grace to pass us without making use of it. Return to the Lord with all your hearts. In 1 Samuel chapter 7, verses 2 and 3, the Word of God says, "Time went by until 20 years has passed since the ark had been taken to Kiriath Jearim. Then the whole house of Israel began to seek the Lord. Samuel told them, 'If you are returning to the Lord with all your heart, get rid of the foreign gods and the Ashtoreths that are among you. Dedicate yourself to the Lord and worship only Him. Then He will rescue you from the hand of the Philistines.' The children of Israel, out of their carelessness and sinfulness, lost the Ark of the Covenant that symbolizes the presence of God. They were seriously being oppressed by their long-term enemy, the Philistines. But here, the Word of God says, they began to seek the Lord. I wouldn't know how far you have gone away from the Lord your God. I don't know what sin has separated you from the Lord. No matter what it is, this is the time to seek the Lord. The happenings around the globe is a sign that everyone who desires to be saved must begin to seek the Lord. In verse 3 of that 1 Samuel chapter 7, Samuel the man of God said to them, "If you are returning to the Lord with all your heart, get rid of the foreign gods." In other words, Samuel said, it is good to return, but you must do it properly. This is not the time to play religion. Yes, we need to return to our Lord with all our hearts. Samuel said, get rid of the foreign gods and the Ashtoreth. I wouldn't know what you need to get rid of, but do away with sin. Do away with any form of ungodly alliances. It is time to renounce membership of secret cults, membership of witchcraft, marine powers, and all the likes. It is time to jettison all forms of immoral ways of life and wickedness. It does not matter where you are now and how bad the picture of your past is. Just come to the Lord in repentance. It is not the time for us to play church. It is the time to sincerely decide where we want to belong. It is time to return to Jesus Christ, the only one who is able to save in this world and in the world to come. Samuel called on them to dedicate themselves to the Lord and worship only Him. It is time for us to dedicate and rededicate ourselves to the Lord. God must be our only and true object of worship. It is time for you and I to stand right. And you know, to stand right is to stand with Christ. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Samuel assured the Israelites, "If you return with all your hearts, then God will rescue you from the hands of the Philistines." The only place of safety and rescue, not only from COVID-19, but also from everlasting doom, is the Lord. He will save you in time and in eternity. Do you want life? Come to the Lord Jesus Christ. In 1 John chapter 5 verse 11, the word of God says, "God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son, Jesus Christ." Are you in him? Stand firm and be sure of your salvation. Don't doubt the ability of Christ to save you. Trust in him, and you will rejoice at last. Your life will not be wasted. Mercy will reach you. God bless you. Amen.